Hello, I'm Mr. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, and I preach Christianity and in spirit, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus, and I was lucky to be born in Punjab, where he came in 1469, and you can see the darkness, how heavy the darkness is. He came, nobody knows him, and they know it only by book and by singing and by turban and beard. Doesn't make you a Sikh. A Sikh means a student of spiritual knowledge and not this physical form. This is the appearance of my body and not of my soul. Sikh is a spiritual self. Not a single Sikh died during 1984 riots. Here I am doing Matthew 18, verse 1 to 5. At that time, the friends, Jesus had friends, you know, no disciples. And not the once-born, spiritually blind disciples of the rabbis. Rabbis, they used to, whatever they told them, they did it without any question. But in Jesus, they were not blind, they were solitary. They were not under Jesus, not following him. Only the blind follow others. But they were listening to him, exchanging views with each other, discussing, as the Samaritan woman at the well did. She was twice born. You can well imagine the spiritual standard of the Samaritans from her. Even a woman could engage Jesus in such a deep discussion. What about the men? So disciples came to Jesus and asked, who is the greatest in the royal kingdom of God? You know, in Jesus we have the royal kingdom of God, which is different from the kingdom of heaven. Kingdom of heaven is of flesh. The keys were with the rabbis, and I have a book on which I have described this kingdom. So, here is the difference between the two, royal kingdom of God and the kingdom of heaven. Christianity is of heart and not of the book. This book, I give it free, but hardly any customers for it. So I put it on internet and revised it, and you will find the revised edition on the internet. If somebody is interested, you can help me in IT to put the book in paper form. I would much appreciate it. It is on e-book, Kindle. The title is One God, One Faith. And you can help me. We can get it published in paper form. So, Kingdom of Heaven, the key to the which was with the rabbi possessed in law and order. When there is law and order, it is heaven, kingdom of heaven. But royal kingdom of God is inside you, in your heart, peace of mind when you have. He called a child an unbiased, righteous person whose heart is crystal clear, or what is inside is outside, free of hypocrisy, whom he put among them and said, truly I tell you, unless you change and become like children, you will never enter the royal kingdom of God. Again, these messianic Jews, they entered this corruption, not of the kingdom of heaven. It is wrong. Kingdom of heaven belonged to the rabbis. So, you have to be careful, you know, of this messianic Jews they have made corruptions. Whoever becomes humble and clean-hearted, like this child, is the greatest in the royal kingdom of God, and not of the heaven again. Whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me, because he can give you the gospel, he can preach the gospel from the heart, as Jesus did. So in Christ Jesus, we preach gospel with authority and not reading the book, you know, this book says so, that book says, that professor, this professor, no more. Like Paul stressed this one in 2 Corinthians 3, that we don't carry any credential, letters of recommendation from the temple high priest that we have degree in theology, PhD, particle, this and that, you know. We go by the simple truth, logical reasoning, and logo is his word. So if you understand logo, you understand his word. And this new wine Jesus prepared at Cana, the 7 vessels were lying in the order in which the Jewish people put it. 7 is concerned with the menorah, which is this one. This is the 7 candle menorah. And there is some old mistake, you know. I call Lord Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ, which is wrong. You can see, you know, you renew your inner man every day. So it says, Brother Christ Jesus, our anointed elder brother, Christ Jesus, not the Lord. So Jesus brewed this new wine in Cana and demonstrated how it is done. These are the vats, this physical body, the earth, you know. So the vats were cleansed off. The old specks of the old wine, that means your heart must be clean like the little child, unbiased, had learned next to nothing, like the born blind person of John 9, who did not learn any, did not go to the school to learn anything. He heard people saying, so he used his common sense, our Holy Spirit. So he prepared the vats by fleshing out the old wine, fleshing out the letters you have learned in the universities and other things. Then he poured the new water in, clean water. That means make the person unbiased. There's no need to have knowledge of this book, or this subject, that subject. What you need is the grace of our Father God. And through Holy Spirit you learn. Holy Spirit is common sense. And then he prepared the new wine through logical reasoning. So this is very simple. And gospel is as simple as ABC. I have learned all this gospel through intuition. You too can learn it. But if you need, have a longing for it. If no longing, you won't get it. It's not lying on the platter. You must be capable of logical reasoning. If you can't reason logically, or you have no capability of intuition, you can't have gospel. Our Father God blesses you.